Greetings. What is it? If anyone asks, you've not seen me.
It's gonna be a right good levy, big and beautiful.
Greetings. What is it?
Pissing in the moat? Oh, he's dead. It's gonna be a right good levy, big and beautiful. It's gonna be a right good levy, big and beautiful.
There's been a mistake. I'm no mage. Greetings. What is it?
Pissing in the mort? Oh, dead!
There's been a mistake. I'm no mage.
Pissing in the mort? Oh, dead!
There's been a mistake. I'm no mage. Greetings. What is it? We shan't pass this way.
Oh, Rainer, whatever would we do without you? Plummet off the cliff like lemmings, no doubt.
Meave squinted and gazed off into the distance. It seemed to her that hundreds of black patches covered the peaks on the horizon. Once she had ridden up closer, she realized these were the windows of homes carved out of solid rock.
Her pride, this was,
sighed Gabor.
Burra's Rump. A city carved out of mountain rock. Hundreds of miles of tunnels, dozens of steelworks, smithies and forges. Now, it's a vast lair to monsters. They ooze from underground, weave their nests, hatch their young, and when hunger hits them in the gut, they prowl down into the pass.
Meave stood at the entrance to the underground city. The monumental gate, cast in bronze, lay on the ground, folded multiple times as a scroll of paper. Out of blackened windows oozed a stench of rotting meat and mold. The queen bent an ear to hear water dripping, and, in the distance, a metallic scraping. A sound akin to chitinous scales rubbing against rock.
The soldiers await your order, your grace,
said Reynard quietly, as if he feared he would wake the beasts asleep in the caverns.
Do you recall my words as we fled Lyria?
Said Meave, turning to Reynard.
You swore you would retake your crown, even if you had to penetrate hell to do so.
Time to follow that oath.
The queen inhaled deeply and stepped forward, her sword raised and prepared to strike or parry. Moments later, it was swinging, biting, as the current tenants of Borrow's Rump came out to meet her.
This stench is foul.
I'd like to make it known that us gnomes don't run so fast. You know, in case you were planning to skip out on the quick.
We'll catch them all!
Ah, damn it! They're hatching! The place is about to swarm with creepers!
have a storm knock out one of your teeth.
Murder a paint.
This way! Follow me!
Though wounded, Meave approached the Shaomar, which lay writhing on the ground. She then ran her sword through its heart, finishing it. Yet so spent was she that she lacked the strength to pull her blade from between the plates of the chitinous armor.
The beast near took me,
she whispered.
It was very close.
The Lyrians reached a vast hall that had once served the clans as their meeting room. The stone benches were covered in sticky slime and insectoid eggs, while bats of varying size hung from the crystal chandeliers. Gascon rummaged through old, weathered bones, surely hoping to find something of value. Gabor, in turn, was at a shut and locked door, grappling with it as if it were a deadly beast. The door finally gave way with a sigh, and the dwarf raised his arms in a triumphant gesture.
It's a storeroom! Should hold Maynard's tools aplenty,
he said, enthused.
Some barrels of alchemical brews in here, too. Lucky there's no sign of moisture. They haven't soaked through. All's we've got to do is throw them out into the corridor and set a bit of fire to them. And woof! We'll have sealed the beasts off from the pass once and for all.
Meave treated the dwarves' instructions as hallowed. Soon after, the mountains trembled from a powerful explosion. Rubble came down and blocked the tunnels. They say the plumes of smoke escaping the window openings in the rock could be seen as far as Aldersburg. Dark clouds hovered over the horizon, and a strong gale snapped their banners.
Damn it! A storm's coming! Gabor! Take us to the nearest settlement! We must seek shelter!
Soon, the Lyrians arrived in Stuhlkamp. The town square proved full of folk. Several dozen dwarves, laden with large sacks and satchels, stood about in smaller groups. When a thick snow began to fall, the dwarves cheered. Tears streamed down the cheeks of several, but Meave could not tell if they issued from some fortuitous occurrence, or if the strong wind had wrung moisture from their eyes.
What is it we witness? Why do they rejoice at a snowstorm?
Asked Meave, pulling her hood over her head.
Well, the blizzard's good cause to postpone their expedition by another day,
Gabor responded.
See, they've been conscripted by drawing lots to be settlers. Found homes in a village in Blackbrook Vale. 7 expeditions have gone that way already, and none survived longer than a year. Valley's cursed. No two ways about it.
Intrigued, Meave proceeded to speak with the settlers' leader. He confirmed Gabor's claim. He had buried many a previous colonist. All had been abnormally thin, pale, prematurely greyed, as if some wraith had drawn the lifeblood out of them. Once the dwarf had finished his tale, he gripped the queen's hand firmly, and promising a generous reward, begged that she and her Lyrians accompany the expedition to Blackbrook Valley.
"'Tain't far. Mere few leagues north along the main road. We'll make the march much easier to ken with the whole army, in case of any danger."
"'I know not how useful our swords can be against curses and spectres,'
said Meave.
"'But leave you bereft and in need I will not. We shall march with you into Blackbrook Vale and see to it that you are safely arrived. Then we will march on.'"
The dwarf sped off to announce the good tidings to his settler brethren. By the time the blizzard had abated, They were ready to march.
Be bold.
Take on challenges, risks even. But before you set out to do anything, that is...
When will you ever learn?
Go, pop, pop.
I only eat corpses, except sometimes they're quite fresh.
You mad? Don't shake that!
Babbit the white of an eye from half a league away.
The chase is on!
Discipline shall bring us victory!
A time to sow! A time to die!
Ah!
We got a job to do.
Thing about slings, they hide well.
My pain serves a purpose.
Wait, you're serious?
Anyone asks, you've not seen me.
Meave had stopped and was removing packed ice from her mare's fetlocks when Gabor Zigrin approached. The dwarf squatted at the queen's side, glanced about quickly, then started speaking in a barely audible whisper.
Your Majesty, I overheard some folk talking in the smithy. Birdies claim there's treasure, true riches, in the hills near Blackbrook Vale, south of here. Stowed away there. And nobody dares go looking for it on account of beasts that have made their lairs there. You've got a wee army behind you. I reckon you can try. Might be worth the risk, eh?
The queen brushed the snow from her knees and, raising her hand against the glaring sunlight, peered towards the mountains. Though tempted, she had doubts. To start, the rocky scree at their feet warned clearly of avalanches.
I shall think on it,
she answered, before vaulting into her saddle.
Blackbrook Vale holds many secrets. Many treasures.
Everything is proclaimed by Paul of the Elder. From here on in, you're on your own, wench.
Oh. Impossible. I can't believe it. Gascon, he... he drank a dwarf under the table.
I've said it before, I think, dear Reynard. You simply underestimate him.
In Blackbrook Vale, you're advised to never stop.
What is this place?
Blackbrook Vale.
Quite lovely.
Aye, and damned dangerous. Keep your arms at the ready.